Should We Stay or Should We Go? Boycotts and Miracles, presented by Kelsey, Jesse, Grant, and Nick. These games were vital to the history of the Olympics. For a time, the U.S. was divided as a nation, but in the end, they united for a bigger cause. The two settings for the Olympics were Moscow and Lake Placid. Moscow heavily campaigned in order to get the bid, whereas Lake Placid only received the bid due to Canada backing out. Moscow was the only Olympic Games where the United States did not medal. Why? Because they were not there. The Moscow Games were proclaimed to be the most glorious games ever, though the games were drastically affected by the absence of Canada, Germany, United States, and 62 other teams. These teams boycotted because of the Soviet war in Afghanistan. Jimmy Carter threatened to take away Americans' passports.
President Jimmy Carter pulled the American team after the Soviet Union invaded Afghanistan in 1979, refusing to withdraw its troops. To enforce the boycott, Carter threatened to revoke the passport of any U.S. athlete who tried to compete. The Olympics were not broadcast here. Only 80 nations took part.
The 1980 Summer Olympic Games in Moscow was a platform for all kinds of talented athletes. There would be no Americans as we boycotted the games, yet there were notable athletes that would go down in the history of the 1980 Olympics. Four of the standout athletes would include Teofilo Stevenson, Kozakiewicz, Steve Ovette, and Alexander Dudyatin. At only 20 years old, Teofilo Stevenson dominated the heavyweight division in Munich and Montreal. Now in Moscow, he was more experienced and beat Russia's Zaev to win the gold in 1980. When American promoters tried to recruit Stevenson, his response was, "I prefer the affection of 8 million Cubans." Russian fans flocked to the arena to watch their fellow athlete Konstantin Volkov compete against Lithuanian Kozakiewicz. Kozakiewicz would upset Volkov and his fans to earn the gold medal. He cleared 5.78 meters, which is approximately 19 feet, to set another world record. One of the most talked about events was the 800-meter showdown between Steve Ovette and Sebastian Coe. Both had previously shattered records, but they had never faced one another until now. Coe was favored to win, but Ovette would pull the upset, earning the gold. Coe later said, "I chose this day of all days to run the worst race of my life." Alexander Dudyatin had been in the shadow of fellow Russian gymnast Nikolai Andrianov. He would emerge into his own in Moscow. He led Russia to team gold and would find his way into Moscow's record books for being the first male gymnast to receive a perfect 10 on ball.
Lake Placid, which successfully hosted the third Olympic Winter Games in 1932, is ready to do it again. There have been changes since 1932. Many more competitive events, many more new facilities, a lot more wonderful athletes.
During the 75th IOC session in Vienna on October 13, 1974, 1980 Winter Olympics were selected to be held at Lake Placid, New York. Vancouver ended up withdrawing before the final vote, and the Lake Placid Games were the last Olympics to be opened by a vice president. The Lake Placid Olympics were held from February 14th through February 24th. Over 1,100 athletes from 37 different countries attended. The ceremonies took place in the Lake Placid Equestrian Stadium, and include the first use of artificial snow in Olympic competition. Eric Heiden was a 21-year-old from the United States. He set record-breaking performances and swept the speed skating events. Heiden's sweep of the men's speed skating event has never been duplicated. After becoming an overnight celebrity, he became uncomfortable and retired shortly after dominating the 1980 Winter Games. Eric Heiden won all five speed skating events from 500 meters all the way up to 10,000 meters, setting Olympic records in every one. In the 1500 meter, he almost fell halfway through before recovering to win by 37 hundredths of a second. In his final 10,000 meter victory, Heiden broke the world record by 6.2 seconds. No one before or since Heiden has won five individual gold medals in a single Olympic Games.
For the Americans, the most memorable triumph didn't even win us a gold medal. It was a victory in hockey, the sport that had long been dominated by our fiercest rival for decades. The Americans defeated the Soviets 4-3 to advance to the hockey championship against Finland. Herb Brooks was the author of this Cinderella story. He shocked everyone by picking such a young team, including 9 players he had previously coached at the University of Minnesota. He inspired a nation by leading his team to a gold medal. Coach Brooks triggered his team's run of games by getting the best out of his young players. One of the top performers was the American goaltender Jim Craig. Craig saved 36 out of 39 in the victory over the Soviets. He posted a tournament best 91.7 save percentage throughout the games.
Johnson over to Ramsey. Vigilantinov gets checked by Ramsey. McClanahan is there. The puck is still loose. 11 seconds. You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game. Do you believe in miracles? Yes! Unbelievable.
After the victory against the Soviets, Jim Craig told the media, "If we don't win tomorrow, people will forget about us." Craig was correct, but he had nothing to worry about as the United States would clinch the gold medal with a 4-2 victory over Finland. This is perhaps the greatest triumph in all of American sports history.
In conclusion, the 1980 Olympic Games made history in so many ways. Despite political expression and groundbreaking odds, athletes came together as a team and did the unthinkable. What started as a boycott ended in a miracle.